And we're back to learning Inkscape, and this time I'm going to show you how to create a power icon. We use the ellipse tool first, hold control to create a circle. Let me make that fully black. So I simply click on this color swatch down here. Now press Ctrl D to copy it and I give it a different fill. I size it down, holding Shift and Ctrl. Now select both path and difference. So I've created a cutout here. Now I need to find the center, and we can do so by having this icon active, so snapping to the rotation center and enable the snapping overall. Drag a guide from left to right and it should snap to the center, and now we know where the center is. Let's create a rectangle, just a regular one, so sharp edges. Let me give that a different fill so that we can see better. I'll put it to the center and then I'll drag it upwards. Then I shift click on the black element, path and difference once more. Select the object, path and path effects, plus sign. We need the corners effect. Use the nodes tool, hold shift, and we can select these four nodes and then drag this icon at the bottom to the inside, and this gives us a curved corner. We need yet another rectangle. Just drag one, give it a different fill so that we can see it properly. Position it just like this to the line, and then resize it. Or we can once more use the guide to position it into the center. Now I use the rectangle tool and I give it rounded corners. Let me hover over the guide and I press the delete key. Select it all, Ctrl G to group it. Now we create a background, use the circle, hold Shift and Ctrl, put it to the bottom, let me size this down holding Shift and Ctrl. I select it all, align and distribute, and I put it to the center. If you don't see your rulers, press Ctrl R, and we need the snap to path active as well. Drag guides just like this out of your rulers. And we need another one at the bottom. That should be fine. And now we can use the Bezier tool and follow our guides to create the shadow element. Then close your path. Let me give it a fill, no stroke. Then I shift click on the red circle and I go to path and division. And now we've got three elements. So the icon, the circle in the background and the shadow, and we can give it different colors. Once you've found a color combination that you like, select it all, Ctrl G to group it, and you can export it just like a regular object. And this is how I can create a power icon in Inkscape. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.